Baraka. I'm a presenter for the FRIS 3 Dean's Combination, and I'm happy to take you through FRIS 3. I'll start with what reintroducing or touching on the group accounting framework so that we see where FRIS 3 fits in. Let's first talk about examinability again. So FRIS 3 fits into the group accounting, where we normally talk about assessing of control, significant influence, or joint control. So when we talk about FRIS 3, it's about these combinations, and that is to do with control. You will also be examined on journal entries, acquisition, which really focus on FRIS 3, subsequent adjustments and intergroups, complex group consolidations, preparation of financial statements. So FRIS 3 is normally integrated with FRIS 10, FRIS 11, IS 27, IS 28, and IS 21. And this also on the complex part, we talk to the change in view of interest, where we'll talk about step acquisition, and this is specifically in FRIS 3. And change in NCI and loss of control in everything. So if we come back again to how group starts, a group starts when an acquirer or an investor acquires either assets and liabilities or acquires shares. When assets and liabilities are acquired, they are acquired in their individual form is assets and liabilities, and the acquirer obtains 100% control of those assets and liabilities. However, because we didn't acquire the entity in its fullness, there is a big issue on whether the assets and liabilities are a business. Therefore, the acquirer has to assess whether the asset liabilities constitute a business, and FRIS 3 has got guidance on assessment of whether the transaction or event of acquisition of asset liabilities constitute a business. When an acquirer acquires shares, there is no doubt whether their shares, which makes up the business, constitute a business. The problem is whether the acquirer has control or joint control or influence. And that's the issue on that one. Now let's focus on acquisition of asset liabilities. One has to go to FRIS 3 paragraph 3 and also use paragraph B7 of FRIS 3. What's the key issue in acquire asset liabilities? The accounting for it depends whether those asset liabilities constitute a business or not. So if the assets and liabilities constitute a business, we can apply FRIS 3. But first of all, we need to apply FRIS 3, B7, to assess whether the assets and liabilities constitute a business. When they constitute a business, it's a business combination. And the biggest difference is that both assets and the considerations are measured at their acquisition date fair value. So if you measure your assets and your liabilities at fair value, then you measure your consideration, the cost of acquiring those liabilities at fair value, the difference can now be recognized as goodwill. On the other side, on the contrary, if it's not a business combination, if the asset liability does not constitute a business, it's called an asset acquisition. In an asset acquisition, the acquirer cannot recognize goodwill. So no goodwill should be recognized. And then how do we not recognize goodwill? We then measure all the assets and liabilities acquired at the cost that has been paid. In other words, we allocate the consideration to the assets and liabilities. When you acquire shares, if we then say it on the acquisition of shares, there are a number of possibilities. First of all, you can acquire a simple investment, less than 20%, and that's a financial instrument you apply as the return every time. Otherwise, if you acquire more than 20% and the voting right gives you significant influence, which is participation in the decision making, that's an associate. You need to consider how you account for it in the separate books. And you apply at 27, either measure that using it cost subsequently, measure it at fair value, measure it using equity accounting, or you can use IAS 28 in terms of measuring or accounting for it under equity accounting. If you acquire more than 50%, then add those voting rights gives you control. That is a subsidiary. You need to consider how you account for in the separate books of the acquirer, which is exactly the same in terms of IAS 27. You determine your cost in terms of IFRS 3. You recognize and measure your investment at cost or in terms of IFRS 9, or which is a fair value coupon of OCI, as the accounting policy closing. In the group accounting, whether we call it the consolidation, IFRS 3 and IFRS 10 are applied. Hence, this is exactly where IFRS 3 is connected on the subsidiary. Otherwise, when you acquire shares, you may also have joint control. It may not necessarily about acquisition of shares though. Joint control is about having a joint arrangement where the parties have agreed sharing of control. And joint control can result with a joint venture or joint operation. Joint operation is accounted for under IFRS 11, whereas a joint venture is accounted for as an associate. After the introductions, presentation one would look at the scope of IFRS 3 and the identification of business combinations. Presentation two would determine the acquisition debt. Presentation three, you'll be learning to recognize and measure the position transferred. On presentation four, you'll be learning to recognize and measure the identifiable assets and liabilities assumed. And the last presentation five, you'll be learning to recognize non-controlling interest in goodwill or